Nevermore Eau de Parfum by Frapin was first launched in 2014, and the perfume behind it is anne-sophie behaghel. It comes in a 100ml bottle only and will cost you around £98. Nevermore has a very impressive opening that's aldehydic, ozonic, there's a little bit of nutmeg, a tiny little bit of pepper, but perhaps most importantly, we get the opening traces of a really lovely rosy, burgundy, winey accord. When the mid of the fragrance comes into play, we get this slight, damp, earthy note in there as well, but mainly we get the deep, winey, rosy, burgundy accord, which is what this fragrance is really all about. For me, this is all about the aldehydes, the ozonic nature of the fragrance, this wonderful rosy, burgundy, winey accord that we get, and the base notes are kind of cork-like, woody, ambery, a little bit sweet, but still showcasing that wonderful, winey, rosy, burgundy type accord. Now, for Frapin, in their current lineup, this is something of a radical departure. This fragrance is edgy, it's melancholic, a little bit gothic-y in nature, quite classy and reflective too. This is definitely not a fragrance for everyone. Most certainly something that you need to try on your skin for yourself to see if this is going to work for you. Now, generally speaking, fragrance has no gender, but personally, I feel like this is better suited to a woman than a man. And the kind of woman that I picture wearing this is a very creative, edgy, confident, daring sort of woman that's not afraid to explore life and love and take risks in her personal and professional life, to take risks with style and fragrance choices, because this is a fragrance that is definitely not for everyone, but in the right situations is glorious. I wouldn't even think of touching this in the spring or summer or in any kind of heat, because it breaks down the rose oxide in this fragrance and it becomes soured a little bit and rather unpalatable, which quite honestly makes me feel sad. But in the evenings, in the cool and cold conditions, I would say in temperatures up to maybe 14 degrees and below, this stuff is so good. It's very impressive, it's deep, dark, melancholic, a little bit somber, a little bit gothic-y, and it will definitely make you think. Also, performance-wise, this is great. A lot of Frapin seem to be afflicted with horrible performance issues, but not so with Nevermore, as this performed wonderfully on my skin, and I really enjoyed it. I also need to mention that as a rose-based fragrance, this is very, very interesting, and off the top of my head, I can't think of anything else on the market right now as of filming this review that smells close to it. Rose is a very trendy note in perfumery at the moment, especially when paired with oud and saffron. That seems to be the holy trinity of this glut of Middle Eastern theme fragrances that all have oud as the main component, that, to be perfectly honest, don't really impress me. They all smell the same. They are all from the same family, the same kind of aroma chemicals and raw materials, and there's no real soul or life or emotion or originality to them at all. And oud is rose oud combo fragrances. It's a very big selling point, and Frapin's take on a rose, giving it that winey, rose oxide-y, aldehydic, ozonic spin, makes for a very unique and impressive fragrance that separates itself from the pack and proudly stands on its own merit. And I think frapin took a little bit of a risk with this, and they should be applauded for doing so, for bringing something a little bit edgy and a little bit different to a market that is sadly very much oversaturated. So, final ratings for Nevermore Eau de Parfum by Frapin. The longevity, I got an easy 12 plus hours on my skin, so the longevity I'm going to give a 4 out of 5. Projection on this was pretty decent, perhaps not as strong as I was hoping for, but good nevertheless. So projection, I'm going to give a 3.5 out of 5. The sillage on this was surprisingly good, left a very nice scent trail behind me, but at the same time, it wasn't anything too much, so the sillage gets a 4 out of 5. Now, for the overall smell, on the right person, worn at the right time, on the right occasion, this gets a 4 out of 5. Personally, I like it. It's a very situationally based perfume. It's very personal. On the right person, like I said, if you're kind of edgy, creative, you take risks, you're not afraid to push boundaries or envelopes, you like to challenge ideas, you have something of an edge about you, I definitely think this would smell amazing for that sort of a person. So for the overall smell, I'm going to have to give this a 4 out of 5. So there you go, that's been my little review of Nevermore by Frapin. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Cheers for watching and take care.